I'm Imke de Pater. I'm a professor emerita at the University of California in Berkeley, and I've been studying planets for many decades. So to study Jupiter and Saturn, as I've done over the past few decades, and their satellites and rings, we learn an incredible amount about these planets. These are giant planets, gas planets, so they don't have a surface. But if you go down into the planet, of course the density will increase. Towards the core, we also find rocky materials. But we observe these planets with telescopes, which essentially just look at the upper atmospheres, essentially just the same what we have on Earth, the troposphere, where clouds form. And we can, for example, detect or determine what the composition of these planets is, which is mostly hydrogen and helium, so very similar to the Sun, and very different from the Earth. But we also find gases like ammonia, which you also find in your window cleaner, methane gas, which on Jupiter is not caused by cows, hydrogen sulfide, pretty bad smelling, and water, of course. Water, just like we have on Earth. And water forms clouds, also on Jupiter and Saturn. And in addition, we have clouds of ammonia ice and some combination of the ammonia and hydrogen sulfide forming what we call ammonia hydrosulfide cloud. So we study these. For example, we look at the profiles of the winds, how cloud features move in these atmospheres. And we see that they move along zonal bands with very high velocities for Jupiter of order up to 100 meters per second, and for Saturn a few hundred meters per second. So this is very interesting and tells us again a lot about the dynamics in the atmospheres of these planets. So we have looked at the gas giants and actually their satellite systems and rings with the James Webb telescope. We get just an amazing amount of structure there. We have to do a lot of image processing because you do not just get the image with all the information that we need and that we can see. But after the processing, we see tiny little features like convective storms in the atmospheres of, in particular, Jupiter I'm now talking about. And we see, of course, the great red spot structure within the great red spot. We see gravity waves. We just see so much that it's hard to just summarize. But it's all very exciting. And the difference with what we see with the Hubble Space Telescope is that we look in haze layers above the main cloud layers. And that really has not been analyzed or looked at very much. So we get information that is completely new, even though we have been there with several spacecraft and have observed these planets for decades. Major contribution is indeed that we study now these hazes above the cloud layers. So that, as I mentioned before, that is something that's completely new. But the other thing that we look at are the ring systems around these planets. It's certainly for Jupiter, the dusty ring, it's challenging to image them, but we have managed. And we look at Io with its volcanic activity. I mean, we have looked at Io with the Keck telescope and the ALMA telescopes several times in the past. And now with JWST, we see usually volcanoes go off whenever you look at Io, which I think is exciting. And we look at Ganymede, where we also see new features, new things that haven't been seen before. So it's all extremely exciting. And Titan and Enceladus in the Saturnian system, Titan, we have just released a press release. We see clouds and we can probe down to the surface of Titan, which is hard to do from the ground because you use wavelengths that we cannot see through the atmosphere. And Enceladus, to just look at the jets, the geysers on Enceladus, will give us a lot of new information on that particular satellite.